Dakota.
Thank you.
church say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let the church praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Yeah.
Let us speak the word of hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I think we all know why we're here. This is called the season of Lent. Where we prepare ourselves for the coming Lord and his resurrection. Amen.
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 I thought I was loud enough.
All right. We come tonight to lift up praise to the Lord our God, and we want to give thanks and praise to this church for opening its doors.
Yes.
Pastor Clark, for being so gracious.
Yes.
Receiving us.
Yeah.
They asked me last night if I would be the worship leader, as we have it in the program, the officiant for this service tonight. And I said yes. I'm a retired preacher, so you don't get much of an opportunity. So you take it what you can get when you can get it. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm just thankful to the Lord for the invitation and for the opportunity.
Right.
And we are going to move right along in our service tonight. We have the Pastor Darren Johnson, who's from the Pastor New Era Missionary Baptist Church. I didn't see him yet. Oh, here he is. All right, come on, Brother Johnson. And we're going to ask Pastor Teresa Lee to be ready. But she always is ready.
Amen. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I found out today, she whispered to me, she'd been cutting down trees. Sometimes when you're the pastor of a church and you don't have all the help that you need, you got to do so much for yourself. You might end up raking leaves in the fall.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Cutting grass in the summer. But you know, just give thanks to the Lord that you have the strength, that you have the wisdom, that you have the power, that you have been given that authority.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
So that's what I am doing. I'm a little older, so I don't do much of that. I got to hire somebody. Amen. No, I had a friend of mine at age 59, and he was shoveling snow. He failed in that driveway. He passed away. So I said, well, I was a little older than he was, so I said, I'm going to learn from his mistake. Amen. And so I don't shovel snow. I don't cut grass. I don't trim trees or bushes. I don't do any of those things. But what I do is give thanks and praise to the Lord. Share this with you. I went to Virginia to the funeral of my sister-in-law. I didn't get to the funeral. I had flu and pneumonia, and they kept me in the hospital for 4 days. Another sister-in-law has been so sick, her kidneys has failed, she's on now on dialysis, and so many things are happening to her. She's just a little older than I am. But I just give thanks to God for every day I wake up, for every breath that I breathe, for every moment I have still yet on this side of the ground. Let Brother Darren come now.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we give him thanks and praise.
Amen. Let us all stand for the reading of the word. Have a Bible you want to follow along. Colossians chapter 1, verse 19. Colossians chapter 1, verse 19 to 23. And it reads as thus: For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell, and having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him I say, whether it be things in earth or things in heaven. And you that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now hath he reconciled in the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. If ye continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel, which you have heard, and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven. I have read Colossians chapter 1, verse 19 through 23. May God add blessings to the reading, hearing, for most of all, doing of his word.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm going to ask, can we all stand in agreement with this prayer? Amen. We certainly give honor and admirations to our pastor tonight, Pastor Clark. The Bible said when two or three are gathered in his name, that he would be in the midst. And I'm going to ask if we would come together and just put our hands and grab that person's hand that's right there next to you. I feel a great anointing in this house. Amen.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Father God, in Jesus' name, we certainly come to you tonight. First of all, thanking you for who you are. Thanking you, God, because you loved us when we didn't have the sense to love our own self.
Amen.
God, you kept us from seen and unseen danger, things that we have walked in, things that we have passed through. Father, you kept us with this unconditional love. We thank you for this service on tonight, and Father, we reference this night as this is the time that you're preparing for the purpose of your coming. We thank you for it now. We thank you, God, that each person that's in this building on tonight, I pray, God, a special prayer over their life. I pray now, God, in Jesus' name, that not one person will leave out of here the same way they came. Some came broken, some came hurt. Oh, my God, some came feeling abandonment. But, God, I pray right now that you heal their bodies now. Heal their hearts, heal their minds, God. Heal even in their spirit, in Jesus' name. We thank you right now. God, we give your name glory because we know, Father, without a shadow of doubt, that it's already done. And we thank you for it right now. Thank you for Pastor Clark. And God, thank you for the Ministry Alliance. And thank you for our president, Pastor Jones. God, we thank you. Thank you for our speaker on tonight. God, we thank you for how you're moving. We thank you for what you're already doing. In Jesus' name, somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Trouble than hell gives me.
Amen.
And this church is seeing the most wonderful things happen with people's lives changing and them coming to know Christ. And every once in a while we have a stumble here, and this young man was a believer and went to the hotel with his fiance and used, and he passed away. It happens a lot in this world. Yes. The only spirit that can deal with the spirit of this age is the Holy Spirit.
Is there a response from the Oakland County? All right, here we are.
Amen. Come on, give God some praise. That you be worthy to be praised for all of the Oakland County Ministry of Fellowship. We thank you, Pastor Pat, for opening your doors and allowing us to share with one another, because that's what ministry really is.
Yeah.
Is when we come together to give God praise,
Amen.
Not separately, but together, lifting up the name of Jesus, knowing that Jesus
Amen.
Can bring about the change that
yeah.
we need. So we give God glory, we give God praise. We thank God for our leader, Pastor Jones, our president, and we thank you for all the other officers. And we just ask you to just open up, let God have his way, and let us really give praise to a God that is worthy.
And now we have a blessed surprise, a good blessing this evening from the Victory in Praise Unity Choir. They're going to come and do two selections for us. And this is the combination of the Church of Valor, Best of the Barge, and New
Thank you. day Wednesday. And we've been coming down here since Monday. And some of us are on this side of the room, and some of us are on that side of the room. And we really never got to know each other. So on this song, I need everybody to rise to their feet and get out of here and go fellowship with one another.
Yeah.
church rejoice, give thanks to God.
Here in the city.
pity patted me and told me I did halfway a decent job. And talk about this choir. Now let's give God a hand of a praise.
Plot against you
and push you
to your purpose.
Look at somebody and say, when your haters plot against you, but they push you to your purpose, you go ahead, and give God a hand clap of praise in here. Father God, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for the word. We thank you for the word that will go forth tonight, oh God. Give me clarity of word, access of speech, oh God. Remove me out of the way, oh God, and pour your Holy Ghost Spirit down inside that you will do the speaking, oh God. Then, God, give ear to the church that they might hear what the Spirit is saying unto them. When your haters plot against you and push you to your purpose. My brothers and sisters, we have come to the fourth day of this holy week. We have come to understand this day is known as Spy Wednesday or Silent Wednesday. The reason it is known as Silent Wednesday because the Bible does not give any real information what the Lord did on that Wednesday during Passion Week. My brothers and sisters, scholars all over the world have speculated that after two exhausting days in Jerusalem, Jesus and his disciples spent this day resting in Bethany in anticipation of the Passover. My brother and sister, Bethany was about 2 miles east of Jerusalem. This is where Lazarus and his two sisters, Mary and Martha, lived. Y'all know who Lazarus is, Jesus' friend. Y'all know who Mary and Martha was, Jesus' cooks, and they followed him around everywhere he went, amen. And you know that same Lazarus that Jesus wept over when he died. And our witness in here tonight, Lazarus had died, and Jesus was not there to raise him from the dead. Lazarus was dead, and yet he was not there at the time to move the sickness from him. Y'all remember the story, don't you? And when Jesus heard that Lazarus had died, he told his disciples, we got to go back and wake Lazarus up. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
And on the way there, brothers and sisters, I got any help in here? He met Lazarus' sister on the road, and she ran to him and said, Master, had you been here, my brother would not have died. But I got a witness in here. Can I serve you? Notice over here at Grace Gospel Fellowship, I learned a long time ago, anything dead should be resurrected in here. Do I got a witness in here? Do anybody in here want a resurrected spirit in here? Tell God, thank you. Hello tonight. If you in a dead end job, you can tell it needs to be resurrected. If you in a dead end relationship, it can be resurrected. I want to tell you, anything dead should be resurrected. Do I got a witness in here? But look what the master says. He didn't get in no long deep conversation with the sister. He just said, show me where you laid him at. She said, Master, he been dead 4 days. And by now he stinks. I ain't got no help in here. I wish I had some help in here. By now he's starting to smell real bad. But had you came when we sent for you, I wouldn't be weeping right now. Jesus never said a word to her. He just said, show me where you laid him. And Jesus got to the sepulchre. Y'all not hearing me. The tomb, if you will, where Lazarus was laid out at. He walked up and just said, Lazarus, come forth. Look at that. I wish y'all would have been there with me. When Lazarus jumped out. I ain't got no help in here. With the grave naked, still tied around his mouth. With the death sheet still wrapped on his face. But he jumped out. Can I help somebody in here? Am I helping anybody in here? No matter how dead your situation, you can jump up out of it. Do I got a witness in here?
Free.
Can I help somebody in here? Yeah. When your battery's dead, you give it a jump start.
That's right.
If we got some dead battery in here, you need a jump start. submit to you, my brothers and sisters, that this Jesus was not laying around resting, but he was doing the will of his Father who sent him. Because according to the word of God, the record is quite clear in the book of Luke, Jesus was in the temple teaching. I wish I had some help in here. I wish I had some help in here. I found great news in that. Even though he knew he was getting ready to face the cross, Jesus did not go home and sit like some of us, somebody, when we have a headache or have we break a nail. Y'all not talking to me. But somebody make it mad in the church. He did not go home and wait on somebody to take his life. The Lord ain't doing to take his life. We have to lay his life down for a ransom. I got a witness in here. Jesus was not just sitting around like some scholars speculated. He was in the temple teaching. My brother and sister, I'm irreversibly convinced that Jesus did not sit down on his job. For the record is clear that you can tell the tree by the fruit it bears. I ain't got no help in here. Anybody here bearing good fruit in here?
Yeah.
Well, what are you trying to say? You're trying to, if you've been called to be on the usher board, stand at the door and be a watchman on the wall. If you've been called to be a missionary, go out and prepare the book when the preacher comes. They can get delivered, set free. I ain't got no help in here. If you've been called to the work of the ministry of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and you're not a good preacher or speaker, keep on preaching to the rocks crying out for you. Am I talking good to anybody in here? Amen. Am I talking good to anybody in here?
Yes.
If you check the record, the Bible said on Monday, he cleared out the temple of the thieves. On Tuesday, brothers and sisters, the religious leader aggressively challenged Jesus' authority and attempted to ambush him and create an opportunity for his arrest. But the master evaded their traps and pronounced hard judgment on them. Do I got a witness in here? Can I help somebody in here? There gonna be some folks that's gonna be plotting on your demise. Hello, somebody. But you ain't, y'all not hearing me. You just be judgment against them. You gotta let them know for God you live and for God you will die. It is God that does the judgment. I ain't got no help in here. You have no help in here. Put me in. Do I got a witness in here? Hallelujah. He pronounced a harsh judgment against them. People said, how could Jesus, who was a Lamb of God, pronounce harsh judgment against anyone? Well, I'm glad you asked. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Come on, preacher.
You know how he pronounces harsh judgment on you?
All right.
Because when you decide to do what you want to do, when you want to do it, how you want to do it, he just lets you do it, hold somebody, until you get back and want to come back to him. Why God wouldn't do it? My brothers and sisters, a hater that plot against you is someone that is jealous and envious and spend all their time trying to make you look small so they can look tall. Do I got a witness in here? My brother says, I thought I should tell you when you make your mark in life, you will always attract some people that will plot against you. I ain't got nothing to have. And matter of fact, if you do something good tonight, somebody gonna plot how to take the root on out here. Do I got a witness in here? On Holy Week, on this Holy Week service, it should not be an empty chair in this place. Matter of fact, the balcony should be full. Because you know when they turn this place into a place of gossipism and coming here worshiping everything they wanted to worship at, and painted all the windows black and came in dancing in a consecrated area. I wish I had some help in here. And the church of Pontiac and all around the county begin to pray for this building. And God heard somebody pray. didn't show up. I ain't got no help in here. I don't want to hear nobody talk the talk. I want to see you walk the walk. The Bible says the tongue is a little member of the body, but it boasts a great thing. That was tonight. The Bible says a man that counts himself to be something, but he knows he's nothing. He deceived him or herself. You would attract some people that will plot against you immediately. That's why you have to be so careful who you share your blessings with and share your dream, because some folks can't handle seeing you being blessed. Do I got a witness in here? Do I got one man or one boy or girl that can stand here and be blessed tonight? Y'all just miss your shot and come right in the net. Is there anybody here on my stand to be blessed tonight? They missed it again. Y'all missed it again. Can you help me grab the ball? Can you help me? Can you stand and be blessed tonight? Can you get it right now? Can you stand and be blessed tonight? Because your God is still blessed. He's the same today. He's the same forevermore. If you're a man, just reach up and pull down what you said that you are. Praise and praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My brothers and sisters, there are some folks can't stand to see you be blessed. You don't believe me? Ask old man Moses. The same family sought to kill him. Well, the same family had to raise him. Do I got any help out here? I wish do I got a praise. Am I talking real good in here? Go over there and ask old man Joseph. Them same brothers that put him in the pit and sold him. Well, the same one he had to feed, hello somebody, when the famine hit the land. Am I talking real good to y'all in here? Just ask those Hebrew boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, I got any help in here. They got put in a hot situation. But look at our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ step right on in. Then you can't ask the men that. Well, don't ask queen to anything. I got a witness in here. Look at Esther, y'all. She caught a hole to the diabolical plot. Though that old conniving Haman plotted against her. I ain't got no help in here. Not only to kill her, but kill the whole nation off. Do I got a witness in here? And when he plotted to kill her and kill the whole nation off, Esther got cleaned up. She put on the best perfume, put on the best diamond or ruby earrings, and began to paint her face real good. I'm giving y'all spirituality tonight, y'all. I can see her doing her hair right now. And as she looked in her wardrobe and pulled out that number 5 dress that she knew would knock the king off his feet. Do I got a witness in here? And then she grabbed that dress and wrapped herself in it. I ain't got no help in here. Can I use gifts of the imagination for a minute, y'all? I feel real good, y'all. And I can make her put the dress on. I gotta save my family. I gotta save my nation. And then she said, you know how it is. When you get dressed up to do the work of God, somebody will come and try to hinder your blessing. And she said, I can't let you hinder me. Y'all know that old Negro spirit, though. No man can hinder me. I can't let you hinder me. If I perish, let me perish. Get dressed up tomorrow and go and see the king, hello somebody, before you go to your job interview. Yeah, some of y'all got a bad report, from the doctor. But I dare you get dressed up and go and see the king. Tell somebody, and he'll change your report. You know, I got a witness in here. Some of y'all want this money, you jump out here, and you change the strain. I dare you go and see the king, because my today. You might be disgusted today. You might be thinking about doing the wrong thing today. But can I tell you something? Just a little talk with Jesus will make everything all right. Just better see the king. I heard Pastor Clark said a young man had gave his life to the Lord, and yet he fell into divers temptation and ended up going home. Well, I want to tell you, Pastor Clark, it don't just happen at Grace Gospel Fellowship. I ain't gonna help in here. 4 hours before I got here, I got a phone call from one of my members and said, Pastor, Bobby's dead. I ain't gonna help in here. I said, what do you mean Bobby's dead? I said, Bobby, who? She said, you know who I'm talking about, my brother Duke. I said, dead where? She said, dead in the house. I said, what happened to him, sweetheart? He said, she said, you know what happened to him, Pastor. Don't play with me. You know most things. But I just need you to come over here and give my family a word of comfort. And of course, I jumped in the car and called my brother, and we ran over the house to give a word of comfort. And we got there. Ain't got no help in here. Well, he was laying up in the upper room, with his legs crossed, hand on his stomach, with closed eyes, looking like he was at peace. I began to celebrate God, because I knew Bobby had already confessed his faults and confessed his sins to Jesus the Christ. And I know no devil in hell can pluck him out of God's hand. So I celebrate God tonight. So Pastor Clark, you don't have to have a heavy heart. He wants to go see the king. Do I got a witness in here? I wish I might tell God, thank you in here. I wish I had just one more witness to understand what I'm going to do. When you know God for yourself, you ain't got to worry about that. But look for the resurrection. My brothers and sisters, some of us are here tonight asking the question, how do you handle your haters that plots against you so that they, you will not abort the mission that God has placed you on? How do you handle your haters who plots on your daily, plots on you day, on daily basis so that you don't miss the opportunity that has been set before you and that God has planned out for your life? My brothers and sisters, I'm glad you asked. How do I handle them? I keep my mind stayed on Jesus. The Bible says, you keep your mind stayed on Jesus. He'll give you perfect peace. Do I got anybody got some peace in their mind today? No matter how they talk about you, no matter how they scandalize your name, you still got your mind stayed on Jesus. Yeah, they fire you from that job, but you got not fired. You got reassigned, because your mind is still stayed on Jesus. Yes, he or she walked out on you and left you with your children. Thank you. anybody in here. I wish I had a praise and pray in church. God don't make no junk. So he gonna give me his very best. Do I got a witness in here? My brother and sister, can I tell you something else? You can miss something better than God has for you. Because you're so concentrated on what somebody else has. Can I help somebody in here? Y'all don't mind if I meddle a little bit. I got a little more time, amen. Y'all don't mind if I meddle a little bit, do you? You know that man, that young man when y'all was young teenagers in school, and he ran track or played on the basketball team or was on the senior varsity team, and y'all was sweetheart, but he dumped you and got that other gal, and now she got 5 or 6 children. I ain't got no help in here. Hello, somebody. And they living in their mama's basement. Hello, somebody. But you was cute, and then you had the right man to come by and propose to you, that had a good job, that had good education, had good ethics, had good worker and moral, had, y'all not hearing me, knew how to treat a woman, but you so hung up on, y'all not hearing me, on Junebug, tell on somebody, you can't see the blessing right in front of you, you better tell it, y'all not hearing me in here, you better drop that, he see right here.
But if they took time out
to go ask the person that owned the house how much their water bill was. They'll know how God, how the grass tastes so green. Do I got a witness in here? My brothers and sisters, I thought I should tell you there are some people that don't want to see you get ahead in life. They don't want to see you get your life together. They don't want to see you get off drugs. I got no help in here. Can I tell you, I'm on drugs too. I am an addict. I'm addicted to the Holy Ghost. I'm addicted to praying. I'm addicted to praising. I'm addicted to worshiping. So I got a witness in here. I'm addicted to lifting somebody up and not pushing them down. So I got a witness in here. She drives me to worship service. She drives me to mission me. Yeah, I'm a drug addict. Can I help somebody in here? And I'm high off of life right now. Come on, tell God, thank you. I just like talking about God and how good He's been to me. Can I help somebody here? Let me tell you something. When your haters plot against you, they hate to see you come to church. They hate to see you praise God. They hate to see you shout in the aisles. They hate to see you dance in the pews. They hate it. You know why they hate it? Because they don't know the record. The Bible says, make a joyful noise, all ye land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before His presence and see it. Know the Lord, He is God. It is He that's made us, and not we ourselves. Do I got a witness in here? Well, you know who you belong to, and who you belong to, and where you belong. You know why I'm praising God where you at? You ain't got to be in church to praise God. You can be in your bathroom praising God. Your praise and your thank you make room for more. Some of y'all don't want no more, but I want mine. Good measure, press down, stick it together, and run over. Do anybody have any more that I got one more? Come on, let's tell God thank you for more is better. Let's give God some praise for what He's going to do for you. I see somebody who's not doing it. I see somebody who's not doing it. Yeah. my brothers and sisters, I discovered after studying this text that our master was plotted not against, but plotted against him, not by his enemies, not by his foes, but he was plotted against folks that should have been in his squad, folks should have been in his group, some of his homies, some of his eight-foot coons. Do I got a witness in here? Can I tell you something? The psalmist said it. I could have handled it. I could have dealt with it better. Had it been somebody that didn't like me. Had it been somebody that I didn't deal with. Had it been somebody I never ate with. Had it been somebody that I always drank with. But it was somebody that took sweet communion with me. Can I tell you something? Your enemy can't get close up on you. It's the one that smiles in your face. And all the time they want to take your place. I want to tell you what they are. Come on, give God a hand. I don't get a little here. You know what I'm talking about, brothers and sisters. I ain't talking about those folks out there on the corner selling drugs. I'm not talking about the folks that at the liquor store selling liquor. I'm talking about the religious leaders, elders, priests, bishop, apostles. Y'all not hearing me? Very dangerous when you start taking scripture and make it for self-interpretation and you have not got a revelation from God. Do I got a witness in here? If you don't understand the scripture, go and ask someone that knows. That's why God gave you a pastor. I ain't gonna let me say this. Let me help you. Faith come by hearing. And hearing by the word of God. How can he hear except he got to hear from what? How can he preach except he be what? I got any help in here? Too many folks are taking the word of God and interpreting it for themselves. You help me, Holy Ghost. I'm done, y'all. I'm about done, y'all. Let me help somebody here. Let me help somebody. I was at a house a few weeks ago, and a young lady told me I could have church all by myself. I can praise God in my living room. I can touch the TV and get my deliverance. And I told her, baby, you don't know the scripture. The Bible says, forsake not the assembly yourself with the brethren. Don't you know that strength and number? Now, can I help somebody in here? Hear about that scripture, say, well, two or three gathered in name, touch me, God will be in the midst. God said, go and get the will and the heart, the blind, the cripple, the crazy, the lame. I gotta have that, that my house might be filled, that was my, that we get out of your seat doing nothing and get in the street and do something like God with it again. I'm done, y'all. The religious leader plotted against him because Jesus' claims outweighed their authority. The religious leaders plotted against him because his deeds outraged the religious leaders. They plotted against Jesus because he was a threat to their very religious system. They plotted against Jesus because he was a threat for their way of living, their lifestyle. Can I help somebody here? And they plotted against our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ because he dealt with people that was downtrodden. He hung out with folks that drank. Y'all not hearing me? Or took drugs. Am I helping anybody in here? They didn't want him to socialize with anybody that was an outcast. And so that messed up religious leaders' thought. So they began to plot against him. Because Jesus had lack of respect for their traditions. He said, I did not come to do away with the law, but I came to fulfill the law. And all the law was fulfilled in Jesus. Ain't you glad about that here tonight? Come on, tell God, thank you. I want to tell you one more thing and I'm out of here, y'all. Can I help somebody here? My brothers and sisters, you should know what your real purpose is. And your real purpose is to serve God in spirit and in truth. Can I tell you something, when you serve God in spirit and in truth, your purpose will be unveiled unto you. What is your purpose? To go and tell a dying world that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God, eternal life. What is your purpose? To lift up your head, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord strong and mighty in battle. Who is this King? The great I am. A bridge over troubled water. Water in dry places. Bread when I'm hungry. Water when I'm thirsty. He's my best friend. He's my company keeper. He's my burden bearer. Do you know him for yourself?
You don't know what he's done.
sometimes it takes a little while for us to really make up our mind, and sometimes we're fearful. Sometimes we are afraid to come to the altar by ourselves. Let me just tell you, you never alone in the sight of the presence of God. Amen. So he's looking for you. Maybe when Pastor Clark preaches tomorrow night, you'll give your life to Jesus. Amen. Be prayerful tonight as you go. And make sure that you are serving a worthy God. Yes. Now we're going to have Pastor Jones to come. Who? Bishop DePage. I think they like the way that he does things. Amen. Praise the Lord. If after that message you don't find the Lord, you are dead. Someone just hasn't pushed you in the grave yet. Come out of that grave! Find Jesus tonight. Well, we have to take a love offering. Now, this is Holy Week, and I know that we seem to be always asking for money. It's part of this week. If we're offended you for that for a moment, get over it! It's time to give. How many of you are got up this morning? Because you gave yourself life? No, because the Savior did. And every now and then we need to give back because of the love of Jesus Christ. How many were blessed by that preacher tonight? Indeed. Praise the Lord. So this is a love offering. Now, he would tell you, reach in there and pass by the 20 and go to the 50. But I'm going to say, grab the 20 and the 50. And give this man a love offering. And then, are you going to handle the other? We've got envelopes. Are you going to do that, Pastor? Okay, Pastor's going to take care of the other. But for right now, if I could get two of the deacons again. And again, don't be offended because we ask you to give. God gave his life for us. We can reach in a little bit once a year and not be upset over it. In fact, it should be bringing us joy unspeakable and full of glory. Well, I'm going to start preaching myself. I better shut up. Praise the Lord. Starting at the back, please come bring a love offering this night. God bless you.
Oh, We ask that they bless the man who gave us this message tonight. Lord, you want to give good things to your people. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Brother Jones, just before you come, I'm going to take pastoral liberty for 30 seconds. Last night I was in the hospital with a heart condition. So was Brother Gibson. Brother Martin's been suffering. Brother Jackson's been suffering. Sister Kelsey, she needs surgery. We got pastors being attacked all over this community. Why? Because we're on the edge of revival. The enemy is attacking these pastors, and before he comes up and closes this service, can I have every pastor in this house stand tonight? Everyone that pastors a church, please stand. And I know I'm taking some liberty. But you all did elect me, and as he said, if you didn't want to have me, you shouldn't have elected me. And I just want to take a few moments to pray. The enemy is trying to take back Pontiac, and it belongs to our Savior. And the men and the women standing here are the called shepherds of this community. And we need our good health back. He's not robbing us financially, but he's trying to take our health so that we can't preach. And I say it's enough. So shall we pray? Father, we come to you right now, knowing that your scripture said, in the Old Testament, by your stripes you are healed. In the New Testament, by your stripes you were healed. And right now I claim the healing first for myself. Lord, you said ask, and it shall be given, Lord, I'm asking. You said if two or three would agree it's touching any one thing. Now, it doesn't mean we can pray for gold and silver, but seeking first his kingdom and his righteousness, and then these things should be added. Lord, right now, we pray for your hand of help upon every pastor in this house, and even the ones that aren't here, so that revival may break out in the city of Pontiac. Now we give you the praise and the glory and all honor for your healing hand. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And now here is our president, Pastor Douglas Jones.
We thank God for you tonight. We thank God for this preacher. We praise God's name. And again, I want to thank God for Pastor Clark for opening up his doors tonight. I mentioned to you last night, and I have those, we want to use this. Hubert Price served as a state representative for the city of Pontiac. I think he served as a commissioner for the city of Pontiac. He did a lot of good things, not only to get jobs, to try to educate the people, but he was a tireless, fearless servant here in the city of Pontiac. We established a scholarship, a perpetual scholarship fund, there at Oakland University. At Oakland University. And we want to keep it going. You all can help us do that. I have envelopes. We gave some out last night. Some people turned some in tonight. They took them last night, turned them back in. We got two more days. We have Thursday and then we have Friday. And so if God would touch your heart, if God would touch your heart, I want you to take one of the envelopes and, put in what God wants you to put in it. Put in what God wants you to put in it. Because we want to make sure this scholarship fund just continues to go on. So that's number one. I want you to do that for me. Now, I've got a couple of announcements. I mentioned to you in April the 1st, at Great Temple. At Great Temple, 6 a.m. Some of you like to get up early in the morning. Some of you like to get up early in the morning. 6 a.m. sunrise service. That's on the first Sunday, the first Lord's Day. There'll be sunrise service there at Great Temple. You may choose to go there. On the 23rd, I think it's the 23rd, at Great Temple, the acapella choir from Rusk College will be there. That's a 5 p.m. service there at 7 p.m. service there at Bray Temple. You want to make sure that you go there. What a blessing that's going to be. This is a powerful month, a powerful month. On the 28th, at St. George Cultural Center, the Crystal Lake District. They will have their 40th year anniversary. I want you to support them if you can. Praise God's name. Now, on two Saturdays from now, April the 7th, for those persons who are interested in buying a home, remodeling their home, refinancing their home, or just want to get information about home buying, from 9 o'clock at 9 o'clock on Saturday, April the 7th at Welcome Church, we will be having a workshop there. People from HUD will be there, appraisers will be there, realtors will be there, you know, Flagstar Bank will be there, other lending institutions, to make sure that you get the right information. And so we encourage you to come out to that. So I left some flyers in the back so that you can take those with you, tell somebody about it. You may have a relative, maybe you yourself want to make sure that you do that. So those are some of the announcements. But now tomorrow night, the dynamic servant of God, who gives so much of himself. Pastor Clark tomorrow night, he will be preaching God's word. He'll be preaching God's word. Pastor Clark, he knows what bait to use to get you hooked. There you go, to come to the Lord. So we thank God for him. That's tomorrow night. Also tomorrow night, we will have the Lord's Supper. We'll have the Lord's Supper here tomorrow night. So you want to be that, the blood and the body of Jesus Christ. We want you to be a part of that. That's going to be tomorrow night. We're going to have a glorious time. And then on Friday, from 12 noon to 3, we have just an array of great preachers, seven great preachers, to deliver the seven last words, the seven utterances from the cross of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We invite you to that. Now, I thank all of you. I'm getting out a little bit early tonight. As a matter of fact, I owed you 15 minutes from last night. And you know what? I'm giving them right back to you. So we're about even. So I can run over. You can run over tomorrow night because I'm even tonight. But we thank God for you. We praise God's name. I want you to stand as we get ready to go home. And I thank God for you. Thank you, Brother Preacher. Boy, I tell you what, you stirred. You blessed me tonight. And I thank God for you. God is good. You know, we get the benediction, you know, the last day. But, you know, I ask you each night to just turn to somebody and tell them, God is good. And I want you to have a glorious night. God bless you.
That's your brother?
My brother, my mama.
Okay, this one was on the door. That's why I got it mixed up. He was on the door.
It's easy to remember. He's only got that. I got all of it.
He said, you're not over there.
I would have come with a tie, but Bishop said no. If it ain't black, don't bring it. All right. I don't got a black tie. I'm sorry.
Yes.
Go catch up with her.
Yep.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Nick Rebus. Yeah. Indeed. Oh.
What?
I just give it to you.
Sure. I got a snack before I came.
Flat. I just leave him in the hospital, and then he went to rehab.
and I couldn't find him. And I found him at the same number.
You want to take Jennifer? I think she went home.
Yeah, she's right there. All right.
I already told you I'm all the time.
I keep office hours Tuesday through Friday from 10 to 4. You can usually find me, unless if I'm not there because I ran to lunch, and I'll be there. I just keep out.
Thank you. And you tell him I said hello, and that I expect a phone.